Hey guys, what's going on? Adrian here. Am I in focus? Yes, I am. Awesome. Hope you guys are having a wonderful Wednesday. Today we're talking about this lens right here. This beauty. I'm just going to get it in focus so you guys can see. This right here, guys, is the 50mm f1.8, also known as the plastic funtastic. It is just a beautiful lens, and this is what we're discussing today. The reason why I'm talking about the 50mm f1.8 today, the plastic funtastic, and why it's such a versatile lens and why I recommend it, is for several reasons we're going to cover today. Firstly, this lens, like, I literally bought it for $80, and this has a maximum aperture of 1.8. 1.8 literally lets in 4 times more light than your average, you know, kit lens that you get on a camera. You know, generally it starts at, like, you know, f5.6 at the longest point of the zoom. This is f1.8 prime 50mm lens. That's pretty damn awesome. I'm going to be showing you guys some footage of what I took, some footage and some photos of what you can get with this lens. Like, honestly, I have these expensive lenses. I have, you know, the Sigma Art series lenses. I got like a 35mm Art f1.4. I also have the Sigma 18-35. You know, I also had the Sigma 24-105. These are all Sigma Art lens series lenses, and they're fantastic. The thing about them and this lens in particular is they're obviously a lot heavier. They're a lot more expensive. They're bulky to carry around. I work on a GH5, generally speaking, so for me, you know, the lighter I can go, the better it is. And I found this lens to be just absolutely incredible. It's just been wonderful to use. It's so light. It's like, I think, like a couple hundred grams or something. You know, it's got a 52mm filter. I'll just show it over there for a second. I'm just gonna adjust this. It's just got, all of a sudden, gotten a bit brighter here. The sun's decided to pop out a little bit. But yeah, honestly, this is an incredible lens. You really can't go wrong with a lens like this. Like, if you guys are on a shoestring budget, you're gonna shoot a music video, or you just need one lens to kind of last with, to start off with, honestly, guys, I would highly recommend this. I couldn't recommend this enough. This lens is just, honestly, just incredible. Like, it's just an amazing lens. I bought it for $80, and I have so many lenses, and now I find myself using the 50mm a lot more. Like, if I need to do like a music video, or if I just want to go out and just shoot some photos or something like that, I will take this lens. Right now I'm currently shooting on the 16-35 Canon L series lens, and the reason is just because I can get really wide if I want to, and I just find it as an all-round great vlogging lens. Now, depending on your budget, there are a couple of variations of this lens. Now I originally thought, because this, it, if you look at it here, it says the 50mm f1.8-2. So I assumed that this was the metal mount. Upon looking at it, unfortunately, it's the plastic mount. Now, I'm going to tell you guys the difference between the f1.8, the plastic funtastic, and the Nifty Fifty, which is the metal mount, which is the 50mm 1.8 STM version. Pretty much the main difference, guys, like, the main difference is the fact that the Nifty 50, the new STM version, has a metal mount. Optically, it's a little bit better. I wouldn't say crazy better. Like, it has seven elements instead of this one having 5, I believe. Also, the autofocus is improved. In terms of quality and sharpness, it is a little bit sharper than this lens, but it doesn't really justify the price. I mean, if you have like another $50-$60 to throw in, then get the STM. If you already have this lens, or if you're looking for a lens that's cheap and, you know, tack sharp as it is, this lens is honestly fantastic. We will talk a little bit now about the pros and cons. It's inexpensive and very sharp, even wide open. This 50mm easily punches above its weight when it comes to image quality and functions. It's under $100, guys. You know, you can buy this used. I mean, I bought this used, and it looks honestly like brand new. It's in very good condition, and I got it for $80, $80 Australian. It's fantastic. The fact that it's a 1 f/1.8, which is just awesome. It's crazy for those guys that, for you guys that love like the kind of bokehlicious image. you're going to be able to achieve that now with this f1.8. Now with the GH5, if you guys have a Metabones adapter or like a Viltrox adapter, the one that gives you like an extra element and an extra stop of light, this will go down to f1.3. That's crazy, f1.3, guys. That's just, it's just awesome. It's really cool. And for $80, you know, a lot of the lenses, that if you know, if you want to achieve that kind of look, you have to be willing to spend over $500, you know? So this is really cool, really cool. Especially if you guys have like a GH5 or an APS-C crop sensor, or you're just gonna love it. You're gonna love it. So now let's talk a little bit about the cons. The build quality on this feels cheap. Obviously it comes with the price, but it just feels so plasticky. I mean, it only weighs 100 grams. It almost feels a little bit hollow in a sense. It's just, you get what you pay for, I guess, in that sense. Another thing about it is the autofocus comes off undefined. It's just, it's a real hit and miss when it comes to the video mode of using this lens. If you want to use autofocus, even if you have a good camera that is capable of good autofocus, this is just, it just doesn't really do the job. It kind of focus breathes a lot. It's just not great. When it comes to photos, however, this is really fast for autofocusing. I just wouldn't use it for video. One more point I'll say, and it's not a huge one, is the bokeh can seem a little bit harsh. You know, if you're really paying attention and you really crop in, you will notice a slight difference that the bokeh isn't that buttery smooth. But if you're just like a normal person that just takes photos and, you know, you want that kind of depth of field, you will be able to achieve it. Unless you're like a real pixel peeper that really want to, you really want to dig in and really analyze the bokeh, that might be a little bit different. But for the most part, the bokeh is actually really good. I just want to apologize, guys. The sun's moving in and out at the moment. I'm actually, you know, lighting with my window at the moment, just bringing in that natural light. So the sun is kind of moving all over the place. So I apologize if, you know, you see me adjusting, you know, my aperture and stuff, and that it's changing and whatnot. I do apologize. The natural lighting at the moment is a bit all over the place. But it is nice that the sun's out. It has been raining the last couple of days. I do want to add, don't let the cheap plastic construction kind of turn you off this lens. Optically, it is very good. Even though it has that kind of construction, that cheap build, optically, it is a fantastic lens. Now, is it worth the upgrade? I mean, there are variations. We've got the the 50mm f1.4, which is very pricey. If you have the money to spend and you need that extra stop of light, like if you really need that extra stop of light, then you can obviously get it. But you're looking, I think it's like above $350. I will put a price in the video for you guys to see in Australian dollars, but it is a very expensive lens for that one extra stop. Is it worth upgrading to the STM version to get the metal mount and the better autofocus? It really depends. If you guys are doing a lot more like heavy video and you guys rely on autofocus, then yeah, probably go towards the STM. This, when it autofocuses on this, it's very crackly, it's quite loud, it's very distinctive. If you need audio and you're in a quiet place, you will be hearing it. So autofocus on this is not really recommended. On the STM, it is a lot quieter. And then you've also got the f1.2, which is another whole ballpark, and it's obviously a lot more expensive. But again, if you guys got like a GH5 or you're using like a camera that's not Canon and you can get a Metabones speed booster and whatnot to use for EF, you get that extra stop of light, guys, you can go down to f1.3, no problem. And then at this point, you might as well have 50mm f1.2 and you don't really need to get one anymore, and this one will do just fine for you guys. So now, let's roll out the B-roll. Hope you guys enjoy. That's it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Please, if you like the video, please give it a likes up. Please subscribe. There will be more content coming out soon. And I will see you guys in the next video. I'm out.